welcome. Is now the best time to be an entrepreneur in India. A young country that's keen on taking risks, keen on not following the straight and narrow, keen on breaking out and trying its own ventures. Well, that's what we're looking at today. Entrepreneurship, if you believe you have it in you, if you believe you have a good idea, is now the time to cash in. With this very special panel now with us, Upasana Gupta of The Little Black Book with us, as Eshuchir Suri, founder of Food Talk India. We're also joined by Anshul Tiwari, who is founder and editor-in-chief of Youth Ki Awaaz, and Kumar Gaurav, co-founder at Sun Bazaar. Thanks all so much for joining us. Upasana, first to you. You know, it's almost becoming a cliche to say that, you know, how does someone not want to go for a tried and tested 9 se 5 ki naukri and try something new? What was it that clicked for you? I mean, and your venture's doing very well and quite successful. But how did you sort of take your first steps?
I think the 9 to 5 actually was one of the initial things which led to this, because everyone has this notion of Delhi. Everyone stereotypes it. And what we really wanted to do was challenge that notion of Delhi. So why is it that everyone entering Delhi goes to Khan Market, and why do you end up going to a mall or the same bar every Saturday or meeting the same people that you've known since you were 5 years old? And then that's when something like A Little Black Book came in to basically make the city more interesting.
Sure. But you know, what I'm trying to ask you is, what made someone like you and the people who came together to create Little Black Book sort of get that confidence? How?
It actually just started with, you know, a blog which would talk about new different things in Delhi. And then when the blog started getting certain traction, certain attention, that's when we're like, okay, people are actually interested in things that are not just printed in every newspaper.
Right. Every, so you believe that there was an interest, there was perhaps a market there, all those who needed something like this.
I think the fact that there's so much disorganization in a place like Delhi and India, and there's a lot of gaps to fill, you just need the right people to fill it for you.
You need the right people to fill it for you. And that's perhaps where, Anshul, you came in. You know, in the run-up to the elections, Youth Ki Awaaz was one of the platforms that was being discussed very passionately. There were all those young out there who wanted to make a point, who got there. And despite all that we say about our youngsters not being involved in the entire political process, we saw this election, that change quite dramatically. But what made you see an opportunity here?
See, my story is very similar to Little Black Book Delhi. You know, in 2008, when nobody was really talking to or about young people. Back in, you know, in 2008, I was in college, and that's when I realized that there's a big need to create one central platform where young people can really talk and express themselves in a more journalistic editorial format. And that's where the whole idea of Youth Ki Awaaz came about. And at that time, Facebook was not around, Twitter was not around, Orkut was the in thing in 2008. So it started at a time when social media was very nascent in the country, and it grew as social media came about and people started taking to different platforms to speak up. So again, a very similar situation where there was a lack of opportunity, and I really realized that there was a big need to fill that gap.
Right. Shuchir, you know, I've been reading up on you, and you've sort of been there, done that. You've tried your hand at a whole host of
birds.
Yes, but that's the good thing, right? Because you're not sort of letting those, you're sort of learning from every experience, I would imagine.
Totally.
So would you say that there's sort of got to be an inherent ability to take risks that is one of the key things?
Yes, risk is one factor, and also support from people around you is a major factor. Earlier on in the days, families were not approving of jobs like this. People would not end up getting married when you are when you're a startup. So now it's more accepting.
I have to interrupt that. Have you guys faced that problem? Has anyone faced that?
Oh my God, yes.
Okay, we're going to come back to that in a minute.
Yeah. So I think it's become more socially acceptable also to be a startup. And also, I feel that media is really helping startups nowadays by because startup is the new word. Entrepreneurship is the new word. So I think overall, it's cool to be a startup now and not, it's not uncool. It's uncool to have a 9-to-5 job.
Right. Yeah, perhaps the times they are changing and how. Gaurav, what's been your experience? Because you're an IIM pass out. And, you know, we keep focusing on the need that, you know, from institutions like the ones that you went to, are India's cream, and where are they? What are they doing? Why don't we have more people like you? When you tried a startup, you tried not just, you know, you tried something with solar energy.
Exactly.
So how did the idea come about? And the fact that you're from IIM, did it go, I would imagine it went in your favor, right? Or not?
So, I mean, it started out with a case study discussion which we had in our classroom, and obviously the common flair of passion which myself and Samarth, our co-founder, shared. So both of us were very passionate about doing something of our own, That is something, you know, that gave us a lot of independence in our own way, had that greater vision of, you know, tackling something. Mm. So the biggest asset, which I feel of an entrepreneur is that he can create his own vision. Mm. You can ask someone to, you know, take a piece of paper and make an airplane out of it. Mm. So everybody can have their own unique designs. Mm. What is my vision? And my vision might be very different from one what others
Absolutely.
Are having, and that
right.
can take it farther. Mm. So that is something, you know, that kind of independence doesn't come in a 9-to-5 job. Mm. And we are more, you know,
sure.
accustomed to working
sure.
like that.
Sure.
So being from an IIM, yes, it did help, you know, approaching new companies, approaching the companies in the solar industry, because solar is an industry where not a lot of youth people aren't there.
Right.
So it's been a traditionally driven industry. The traditional mindset is there.
Right.
So we had a lot of challenges also. I personally had. Because the traditional mindset that you are from an IIM, you're already getting a good job, why to quit
it?
So
why exactly?
And yeah.
Did you have to sort of work on this or convince people around you, the kind of people who support you, which you're just talking about here, but do you have to sort of
exactly.
convince them, I do not want to go to, I mean,
yes.
I don't know,
so those challenges were there.
Challenges
were there, and I had to convince, you know, people around me. Friend circle was always supportive because they can more relate to, you know, ideas and mm. your vision and passion about it.
Mm.
But there are certain sections in the society, especially the relatives and all, mm. who feel that, you know, it is not the right way to go about.
Hmm.
Probably they have a traditional way of thinking.
Right.
But we here now, you know, with a, as Sushil said, it is now more prominent, you know, with the help of media that
right.
startups are coming every day. And
right.
that bodes well with the future generation.
Right.
So it kind of
helps,
becomes very cool. Yeah.
Right. I think it helps with the governments also looking at it. We saw a
exactly.
special focus on startups. Upasana, coming quickly over here, you were talking about your experience and having to convince people around you on the need to go ahead with this and not have a... you know, typical pakki naukri, as it were.
I think more than convincing people, it's about convincing yourself.
Mm.
My partner and I both were in typical 9-to-5 jobs. She was at the BBC. I was with the Times of India for
mm.
about 2 years.
Mm.
And that's when Little Black Book was in its 6th month
mm.
or so. And that's when we decided to take the plunge, because
mm.
you have to do something that's unheard of or something that's seeming wrong to everybody else,
mm.
fail to actually do something with a vengeance.
Mm.
And that's where it all began. Obviously, people called it unrealistic because I think...
They did.
When we moved into the space, there weren't so many sort of platforms,
mm.
so to say. There were people who were listing things,
mm.
but not so many people looking for personal experiences to be
mm.
shared
mm.
online
mm.
and for free and filtered information.
Mm.
So I think initially there was a big question mark on whether it's going to work, whether it's not
right.
going to work.
Right.
But then what we saw was there was a very small group initially of people following us, but that group was really strong.
Mm.
You know, the people who've always followed the content have been people who actually care.
Shuchir, tell me one thing. Is this, when someone branches, of course, they have a great idea. They believe passionately. You know, you have to sort of believe in it yourself. You have to have the confidence and all of that. But somewhere inside, I mean, how much does the fear of failure play on your mind? Is it there? Okay, or is it possible to, in this scenario, to carry on not really thinking about it?
So
how does it work?
I have actually gone through 3 planned startups before this,
hmm.
and all 3 of them failed.
Hmm.
So then I finally took a call, I got myself a job, a 9-to-5 job. I was working for a WPP company, and this startup of mine, Food Talk India,
hmm.
happened by accident.
Hmm.
So I had to go out, I wanted real-time suggestions. There are websites in the market,
hmm.
but I would not get people suggestions.
Hmm.
They would not be real people, they would be people I don't know.
Hmm.
So the idea was, I was seeing communities being created everywhere.
Hmm.
So I just created a community,
mm.
and the startup kicked off for me.
Right. What did they say about the best laid plans, right? I mean,
best?
This is how things just fall
yeah.
into place.
Accidents,
right.
always.
Right. Anshul, what is the one thing that you would say that has worked in your favor, or maybe 2?
It's actually tough to zero down, you know,
sure.
the whole
mm.
journey to 1 or 2 things.
Mm.
But, you know, just to shoot off from what Shuchir was saying,
mm.
You know, the idea of failure right now
mm.
is so taboo that people who really want to become entrepreneurs,
mm.
they don't take that plunge because they fear failing. And the amount of pressure we build on people who fail just because they fail is just too much.
Right.
And, you know, that pretty
and
much...
I think it's a society. We lack
it's
the
culture.
Appetite for
Absolutely.
Risks also. Right?
Absolutely.
When we talk about a team and we talk about people working with you, you need, I would imagine... similar commitment and similar zeal in what you believe in, you know,
Absolutely.
Especially when you're trying to do what you are, trying to get the youth to have their say. We've known, you know, by and large, them to sort of, you know, sit back and say, it doesn't concern me, you know, mera kya jata hai kind
mm-hmm.
of attitude. But here we saw almost a radical sea change.
Absolutely.
What do you credit that to?
See, there are two different things. One about the team bit, where you're trying to look for similar people. It's extremely difficult to actually find similar people with same kind of commitments. And actually, sometimes it's very unrealistic to expect your team to have the same commitments as the founder, you know, himself or herself. Because you've started up with an idea, you have the same passion. Not everybody will have the same passion, and you need to accept that and, you know, move on with that fact.
Is that frustrating?
Sometimes it is. It is quite frustrating. But at the same time, if you have a team that does come on a common ground with that same passion, I think that's enough to pull you through. Because you really need people who don't just work as you say, who question you back, who really are radical, you know, who themselves want to take risks.
Chuchir, what, you know, from your experience, you're saying that you've been there, done that, this one has worked, seems to be working, the others perhaps were different and you will learn from it and all of that. But what do you think that you have learned from your experiences, particularly your failures? You know, Anshul is speaking about the fact that we don't look at people who perhaps don't succeed in one attempt, two attempts, the way we should.
For me, it was more about, if I did not go to a B school, I've learned from my last three experiences. I've learned how to create a business. You learn HR practices, you learn marketing, you learn an overall how to run a business, how you have employees, how they're supposed to be treated. And in this day and age, what has changed for me completely and the country right now is that for the first time, the government is looking at startups.
Right.
So that has given everyone a boost. Now the government has, in the union budget, they've budgeted for $1.6 billion
to
help startups. So that has given the whole country a boost right now, where everyone wants to quit their jobs and get into starting something.
Right. But is it that easy? Is it as simple as sort of just, you know, having an idea? I want to ask all of you, what is the most important thing that you believe you need try and make a success out of it?
Because a vision.
Okay.
And scalability, for me.
For you. Yeah. Upasana?
I think quality and consistency and a good team that believes in both those things.
Okay. Anshul?
Yeah, I mean, you really do need focus. And if you have the idea, it won't work till you really focus on what that one thing that you're executing really is.
So I'll pick a point from each one of them. So it's like
the joys of being loud.
Yeah. So it's like you know, having a vision, but that focus to ascertain that you know you're consistently driven by that fact that yes, this is the vision that you want to follow, and you have that passion constantly running into it. And then the team is a very important factor because execution boils down to the team. One point which I would like to add is, you know, it's not about only having the common sort of passion, but also the diversity, the skill set that you have within the team. And that adds a lot if you are, you know, starting off with a new company, because the diverse skill set you have, it is easier for you to range into kind of different sections of, you know, operating a business. So it further generates more revenues for creating more market. And then the last thing which I feel is the addressable market. So that is something which is very, very, you know, important in a country like ours. And that is a positive aspect because we have a huge population to cater to.
So, and we have so many gaps to fill. I mean, you name it and there's a gap there that can be filled. And we have a young population that's out there with all these great ideas. And they're not, I think most significantly, they're not risk averse, which I think is just absolutely critical. Well, it's time now to slip into a quick break, but the conversation continues right after this. Don't go away.